Dear students, today we are going to discuss about capacity of AWGN channel. It is a topic in the third module of the minor course Digital Communication for S4 students. So, let us see. AWGN channel is represented by a channel with information or input signal and the noise added to this channel, and the received signal will have the presence of noise. So actually the noise added to this channel during the communication will be a white noise with a Gaussian distribution. So since this noise is added to this message or information signal, so this is called additive white Gaussian noise. And actually the Gaussian distribution for the noise will have the form like this. Suppose f of x is a function and its Gaussian distribution noise will have the Gaussian distribution like this. So actually it represents the probability distribution function. So AWGN means additive white Gaussian noise. So it is added to the channel during the transmission or during the communication, and it is white noise because its power spectral density will be flat for positive and negative frequencies. That is why it is getting the name white. And Gaussian means it will have a Gaussian distribution, and it has random nature, so it is called a noise. So the power spectral density for the white noise is represented by this curve. So whenever f is plotted against power spectral density, you will get a flat curve having power spectral density value is equal to n0/2. Okay, this is n0 is noise power. So the power spectral density for noise signal is white noise is equal to n0/2. Okay. So in the case of the white noise, two-sided power spectral density is n0/2. Actually, there is no meaning in saying positive and a negative frequency. Actually, there will be only positive frequency, but for mathematical manipulation, we are saying about a negative frequency. Whenever it comes to the one side, actually this represents a two-sided power spectral density. Whenever it comes to the single side, that means to the positive side, then it will be having a value n0. So actually this is the actual one, that is power spectral density, that is a one-sided power spectral density, and its value will be n0. But for mathematical manipulation, we are saying that negative frequencies will be there. Actually in practice there will not be any negative frequency. Sometimes in mathematical calculation we are saying that j omega, you know, j is imaginary, but there is no meaning in imaginary part j. Okay, so these all are for mathematical calculation. Like that, we are creating this negative frequency side. Okay, so whenever we are splitting this one-sided into two sides, that is one for the positive frequency and other for the negative frequency, then this n0 will be splitted into n0/2. So for positive side it will be n0/2, and for negative side it will be n0/2. And if we are combining it, we will be getting n0 to the one-sided. Okay. So we can say one-sided power spectral density will be equal to n0. And actually this represents a AWGN channel. Suppose the input signal power is equal to PI. So with the input power PI, the capacity of the AWGN channel is given by the equation 1/2 into log 1 plus PI by PN, and that log is base to the power 2, where PI is the input power and where PN is the noise power, and its unit is bits per second or bits per symbol or bits per message. So this is the capacity of a noisy channel. Okay, so we will have to consider the noise power and the signal power. Okay, actually this in the case of a communication channel, we cannot control the noise power because it is actually random, or it will be added from the outside world. So we cannot control, we have any control over this factor. So in order to improve channel capacity, what we have to do is we have to increase the strength of the input signal. So but by selecting high input power, that means by selecting high input signal power, we can increase the channel capacity. Okay, if even though there is the presence of noise, we can improve the channel capacity by increasing the signal power or input signal power. That means we have to send the input signal with more power or with high power. If the bandwidth of the channel is B, then this channel will support a maximum of 2 × B samples per second. Therefore, the capacity in bits per second is equal to C1 equal to 2 × B × 1/2 log 1 plus PI by PN. See, suppose if we are considering the bandwidth of the channel and if the bandwidth of the channel is B, and if it can support a maximum samples of 2 into B times the samples per second, then the total channel capacity for such type of channel in bits per second will be equal to C1 equal to 2 into B into 1 by 2 into log 2 1 plus Pi by Pn, okay? And this is the channel capacity. Let it be, we can represent it. Now, previously we represent the channel capacity as a C. Now we are considering the bandwidth and the maximum number of symbols in that bandwidth. And so we can represent the corresponding channel capacity as C1. That will be equal to 2 into B into 1 by 2 log 1 plus Pi by Pn to the base 2. Actually, this is in bits per second unit, okay? So C1 will be 2 and 2 get cancelled. So we will get C1 equal to B into log 1 plus Pi by Pn to the base 2. Here you can notice that we want to increase the channel capacity. Then only we can send more information through that channel. So in order to increase the channel capacity, what parameter we have to increase? Either we can increase B or we can increase input power. Actually, noise power, we have no control over the noise power, so let it we cannot consider it. And so if we are increasing bandwidth, channel capacity will increase, that this equation says, okay? Okay, that's fine with this equation. But if you want to increase channel capacity more and more, we will force on this that bandwidth should be, we will increase the bandwidth. But actually, what will happen in real life, that whenever bandwidth increases to a certain level, then the channel capacity will not increase after a certain level. So let us see. That means we assume that whenever bandwidth is infinity, then channel capacity will be infinity. But actually this is not possible, because when bandwidth increases, the noise power also increases. So we cannot increase the bandwidth above a certain level. After a certain level of bandwidth, the capacity remains constant. So let us see. So whenever we are increasing bandwidth, the noise power also increases. Here we can write the equation for noise power as, it will be obtained by the integral of the power spectral density of the noise. So here the integral will be integral minus B to B power spectral density of noise into DF. So we know that power spectral density of the noise is N0/2. So N0/2 into integral 1 DF. So it will give you F. Okay, so this equation will become N0/2 F within the limit minus B to plus B. So when you are substituting the upper limit minus lower limit, you will be getting N0 into B. So what will happen? Whenever B tends to infinity, C1 will have an equation. C1, whenever B tends to infinity, C1 equal to limit B tends to infinity, B into log 2 1 plus Pi by, instead of P, and we can write N0B. So that will be the equation whenever bandwidth is tending to infinity. So here we are making a substitution that limit B tends to infinity is keeping there, and we are multiplying this equation with the factor Pi by N0. Similarly, since this factor is introduced here, we have to nullify its effect. So we are multiplying it with N0 by Pi into B into ln 1 plus P0 by N0B. So here you can take Pi by N0 outside, so it will become limit x tends to substitute. Suppose Pi by N0 is taken outside, we are substituting that here. Instead of this N0 into B, we are substituting that it will be x. So we can substitute it as N0 B Pi is limit x tends to 0. So B tends to infinity means x tends to infinity. Instead of this term, it will x comes plus ln into 1 plus p 1 plus 1 by x. So this is the formula. Okay, here this is not P0, this is Pi. Okay, so the instead of this term x comes. So whenever B tends to infinity, x will be tending to infinity. Okay, so we can write this equation. But you know about this relation in the case of limit. You might have studied about the limits in the case of plus 2. In that case, you might have known about this formula, that is limit x tends to infinity, x log 2 1 plus 1 by x will be equal to log e to the base 2. So C1 will be equal to Pi by N0 into log e to the base 2, value is equal to 1.44. So you can write the channel capacity will be equal to 1.44 Pi by N0. When it happens? It will happen whenever x tends to 0. When x tends to infinity? Whenever N0 B by Pi, that means whenever B tends to infinity, x tends to infinity. So what is the meaning? Whenever we are increasing the bandwidth to infinity, the channel capacity is limited to a value 1.44 into pi by n0. Initially, whenever B is increasing, the channel capacity also increasing. But whenever it increases to infinity value, channel capacity will not increases to infinity value. But channel capacity will touch the point 1.44 into pi by n0. At this point, the channel capacity value will be saturated. Okay, that is its meaning. So here pi by pn actually represents the signal to noise ratio. Okay, so we can write it as pi by pn equal to signal power by noise power, that will be equal to pi by n0 into b. So you can draw the value n0 b by pi is plotted against the channel capacity, then you will be getting that here n0 b by pi is the quantity that is varying. That means b is increasing, then this n0 b by pi also will be increasing, corresponding channel capacity will be increases. But whenever it reaches a value, bandwidth reaches a value infinity, then the capacity will be striking to the point, it will be saturated to the point 1.44 pi by n0. Okay, here we are taking in the x side, we are taking the channel in the y-axis we are plotting the channel capacity, on the x-axis we are plotting this quantity, okay, x value. Okay, so that's all about this channel capacity. So whenever we are increasing the bandwidth, the channel capacity increases, but whenever bandwidth increases to infinity, channel capacity will not move to infinity value, rather it will stop to this value 1.44 pi by n0. So this is the capacity for the AWGN channel, and you have to by heart this equation and also this equation. This will be helpful for doing problems. That's all about this topic. Thank you.